With me in studio today, I've got David Dickens. David, you are the expert on direct marketing. We've brought in the expert. So, I mean, your history is, right now, you're the CEO of the Direct Marketing Association, a position you've held for 6 years. You also have your own business, big data, digital marketing, a company called ByteStreamer.
ByteStream.
Let's talk about then the direct marketing that the businesses would be speaking to the consumer in an electronic format, email, messages. I loved the way that you positioned it earlier, where you said that direct marketing is where you're in someone's private space, their phone, their inbox, unsolicited.
Yes. So they come to me, David, can I use a call center method to get to customers? Is Section 69 going to block me, close my business down? And I'm like, no, hold on, it's not. So there's two parts to it. There's the call center element, which you are allowed to call people at first point to sell. So you can call, and I get a lot of calls myself. You can call me and I can then listen to you and I can say no, thank you, and put the phone down. So at the cold face of it, the consumer has the power in their hand to say no, thank you, and put the phone down. So Poppy is not restricting you in making that call from a call center, human to human interaction. Obviously, the IVRs and the computer-based dialers.
That's my best.
That's
where you pick up the phone, you answer it, and it says a recorded message trying to sell you something.
No, that's
so it, that would be.
They've taken the power out of
that would be out of
my hands. I'm being instructed by a computer, and I go no. I'm just No, I think the Poppy is clear on that.
Now, if I want to do direct digital marketing, what are the steps that I need to take before I embark on the journey?
So, Section 69 has allowed for us to make the first right of call. So, you need to openly and honestly express who you are, what you're selling, and not make the sale at the first point of call. That's important.
That's important, okay.
Because then you're violating the code and the law. So you need to ask for permission and you need to let them know what it is that they're going to give permission for receiving. Explicit consent. If they don't respond to you, it is not explicit consent.
Right.
Perhaps they've missed the message and you're going to use another interesting way to get...
Like a call center, then you could phone.
You'll use another, and say, this is me, this is who I am. You can also do it on their inbox and say, good day, I'm... You know, just giving you intro to my business.
So if I did it on my first opt-in call contact to you via SMS and it was no response received, could I then pivot and do it on a different electronic medium to your email?
Yeah.
And that would be okay.